are a lot of us right now wondering how we rebuild our finances and our credit. And this week, you have a lot of opportunity to look at the resources available to help you do just that. It is the fifth anniversary of Money Smart Week here in Wisconsin. Our financial expert, Rose Oswald Poles with the Wisconsin Bankers Association, is here to talk about getting smart about your credit. First of all, thanks for joining us.
You're welcome.
Appreciate it. There are more than 500 events happening
in Wisconsin. A great week, and many of them are free. In fact, almost all of them are. So look around somewhere in your county. There will be events this week to take advantage of.
All right. We're going to provide some links for you so that you can see what's going on in your area. But, okay, we're starting with the basics. You want to talk about what lenders look at when they evaluate a loan application.
Well, just quickly, you know, anytime you apply for a loan, credit card, traditional car loan, mortgage loan, whatever, there's four basic things that they look at. First is your character, which is really looking at, you know, are you stable in your employment? What does your payment history look like? Collateral is the next thing. You know, what kind of value property do you have to provide to secure that loan? Then capacity. What kind of ability do you have to repay the loan? Again, that's also tied to your credit history. And then just your credit, looking at what kind of payment borrowings have you done in the past. And again, how have you done on that?
Changing it all given the entire landscape, it seems.
Well, there's closer scrutiny. Yeah. You know, of course, people, credit got a little too easy. And unfortunately, credit card balances got a little too out of control in particular. And, you know, that among many things, as we all have heard, related to the housing crisis, you know, all those factors help contribute.
Fewer people, though, right now are using credit. Is that
still
the case?
Fewer people are still using credit, and that is a good thing. You know, you want to maintain some level of credit use, though. I wouldn't avoid it entirely purely because you want good credit history in the future. You know, most of us don't have cash to buy a car, certainly to buy a house. Yeah, well, right, you know, but it has to be within your control. You know, you can't go crazy, but you want to keep your high score or improve your score if you need to, and showing responsible use of credit is how you do that.
That's important.
Yeah.
Okay, so we want to also talk about, you know, if somebody's, I want to ask you this, if somebody's struggling, though, to get a card, or how would they, if they've let go of everything, how do you even get back into that mix?
Right. Rebuilding your credit is challenging, and certainly if you were forced to get rid of all your credit cards, for example, trying to apply for a new one is challenging. I would suggest you start with either a department store card or a gas card from one of the gas stations. They tend to be a little easier to get. Of course, you're not getting huge balances, you know, for you either.
So $1,000 for gasoline.
Right, but it's a place to start.
Yeah. Okay. You want to specifically talk about rebuilding bad credit?
Right. Well, certainly if you do have past due bills, you know, you've got to get those current. That's certainly the very first thing, is to try to clean all of that up. And then, as I just indicated, if you have bad credit and it's really left you with no credit cards, consider applying certainly only for one card. I mean, you don't want to wreck your credit score. So keep your applications down to one and consider the department store gas card. Build new credit habits, you know, pay your bills on time. Don't charge more than what you can afford to pay for. And use only a small amount of your credit line that you have available.
Okay. And some thoughts on what people should avoid when analyzing their credit choices?
There's lots of credit choices out there. I would really stay away from payday lenders and check cashers. They're very enticing.
Reminder.
Yeah, huge reminder, but boy, 9.9 out of 10 times, they are not good for consumers. The interest rates that you can rack up and the rollovers of your loan become a big problem. So go to a traditional regulated financial institution, even for small dollar emergency loans. They will help you out. Second is just carefully review the fine print on your credit card offers. A lot of them come with rewards. Look and see whether those are really worth the benefit that they claim you're going to be getting, the reward you're getting. Balance transfers, you have to read the fine print very carefully on that as well. And finally, just don't rush into any decisions on your own. You know, ask professional help. Go to your local bank. The lenders there are very happy to talk to you and work through what options are really the best for you.
We've talked, paying bills on time, though, is a big one.
Paying bills on time, very important.
All right, yeah. Some great reminders, insights, and again, we'll post the link to Money Smart Week on our web channel, NBC15.com. Rose, always great to have you back in. Thanks so much.